Christmas program that we've done for a while. I don't know if we've ever done it. Since I've been here, we've never done it this way. So we're going to open up this morning first with the lighting of the candles. And so I want to quickly take you through the journey that we've been on.
No, did you get one?
So I'm going to have my two candle lighters up here. Can you guys work together on that while I'm sitting here? Good. Because I couldn't. How'd you like it? So, our first candle. Who remembers what our first candle was?
Hope.
And we know that we have hope in Jesus Christ. Go ahead and light it. And He is the one that gives us our hope. He gives us our strength, our encouragement, and we know that if we are following Christ, that we have hope after this life. And so we light the candle of hope. What was the second candle?
Peace.
Very good. The candle of peace. That would be that one. And with that hope, we also find that we have peace in knowing Christ and following Him and giving Him glory, giving Him honor, and giving Him praise. And so we can rejoice in knowing that. And so in that rejoicing, what would be our third candle?
Joy.
Absolutely, that's the pink one. That's the pink one. Okay? And so we lit the candle of joy. And these are all attributes of Jesus Christ. We find our joy not just in being happy, but in choosing to follow Christ, we gain hope, we have peace, and we are able to rejoice. This is the candle of rejoicing. I love watching these two work together. You guys are great. There you go. See? Remember teamwork? Makes the dream work. All right. So, today is special because we light our fourth candle. And our fourth candle represents love. And love, and I've talked about this before in different messages, is that love is the foundation that we build on, that Paul built on in his teachings when talking about Jesus. It's the candle of love. And the love of Christ gives us hope, gives us peace, and gives us joy. Go ahead and light it. And we have love in Jesus. And His love we found on the cross and most of all in His resurrection. That He chose to come down and be with us as we celebrate His birth in a couple of days. We celebrate Him coming to this earth and being among us. And that is where we find our hope, our peace, our joy, and most of all, love. And then on Christmas Eve, and this is our slide up here, we will be at Waukeshma Community Church at 6 o'clock to light the Christ candle, which is the middle one. You'll see that button. And so we rejoice in all these things. And this is why I love celebrating Advent. And again, I always remind people, this is a man-made tradition, but it's a fun one to help us focus more on who Jesus is. And so as we begin our program today, may we rejoice in knowing Him. So as we do things a little differently, we prepare for offering. And as we do our offering today, Leroy is going to come up and share a song with us so that as we give back to God, we can remember the sacrifice of Jesus at the same time.
Offering.
So, if you will, please pray with us as we move into our offering. Do you have somebody praying today? Or
Father God, we thank you for the time and the season that you've given so much for us. And we just ask that you would want to give them back while we're headed together and keep us all praying for you. Amen.
Go to the gallon.
that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters. Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? This child that you deliver will soon deliver you. Mary, did you know that your baby boy would give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would calm a storm with his hand? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels trod? When you kiss your little baby, you kiss the face of God. Oh, Mary, did you know? Mary, did you know?
Just in the last 3 months, people that have gone to be with you. And Father, it's, we rejoice that they are with you, but they also mourn missing their loved ones. And we just pray that you will be with them throughout this time. Father, we also pray for Kind Scott, who needs a place to live within her budget, Lord. And we pray that you will just be with her and just provide for her needs and draw her near to you. Father God, we give this worship service to you, and we pray that you will help us to honor and glorify you with all that is ours. And we lift this all up in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, we invite the kids to come up, and they're going to share a song with you guys.
Blindness will pass away. No. Angel, I don't know. Thank you.
While they're coming up with their love track, I just want to let you know that the gospel fuzzies have been around for a long time. We used to do them with a puppet ministry. We had sent 50 of them with the shoe boxes.
Up there, sir.
And anyway, just pay attention to the words. It has a lot of meaning on the colors and the kids. Stephen has worked with the kids, so they know the song, and they know what it means. So I'm going to turn it over to him.
We started singing this song a few months ago for children's, for Sunday school songs. And I told them that the colors from the Gospel Fuzzies are the colors of the word of this book. This is a more fun way to memorize them. And they've learned the song very good, so they'll sing it for the Christmas program. So I said, we'll do it.
Okay, ready?
Here we go.
We're the Gospel Fuzzies. Gold stands for heaven. Gold stands for heaven where we want to be. That means we are sinners.
Now I shall be made into a beautiful treasure chest. What treasure I shall hold, the first tree thought. The second woodcutter looked at the second tree. This tree is strong. It's just the right tree for me. With the swoop of his axe, the tree fell. Now I shall be named to a mighty sailing ship and sail waters just for kings and queens. The third tree felt her heart sink when the last woodcutter looked her way. She pointed tall and straight up to heaven, but the woodcutter never even looked up. Any kind of tree will do for me. With a swing of his axe, the tree fell. The first tree rejoiced when the woodcutter brought him to a carpenter's shop, but the busy carpenter was not thinking about treasure chests. Instead, his work-worn hands fashioned the tree into a feed box for animals. The once beautiful tree was not covered with gold or filled with treasure, but covered in sawdust and filled with hay for hungry animals. The second tree smiled when the woodcutter took him to a shipyard, but no mighty sailing ships were made that day. Instead, the once strong tree was hammered and sawed into a simple fishing boat, too small and too weak to sail the ocean or even a river. Every day, he went to a little lake and brought loads of dead, smelly fish back for people. The third tree was confused when the woodcutter cut her into strong beams and left her in a lumberyard. What happened? The tree wondered. All I ever wanted was to stay on the mountain and point to God. Many days and many nights passed. The three trees nearly forgot their dreams. But one night, golden starlight poured over the first tree as a young woman pours a newborn baby into the feed box. I wish I could make a cradle for him, her husband whispered. The mother squeezed his hand gently and smiled. This manger is beautiful. It's just what we need. Suddenly, the first tree knew he was holding the greatest treasure the world will ever know. One night, a tired traveler and his friends crowded into a small fishing boat. The traveler fell asleep, and the second tree quietly sailed out to the lake. Suddenly, a thunderstorm arose. The little tree was scared. He knew he did not have the strength to carry so many people safely back to shore. The man awoken, and he raised his hand and said, "Peace." And the storm left as quickly as it came. Suddenly, the second tree realized he was carrying the best king of all, the king of heaven and earth. One Friday morning, the third tree was startled when her beam were yanked from a forgotten wood pile. She flinched as she was made into a cross and carried through the streets with an angry crowd jeering at her. She shuddered as soldiers nailed a man to her. She felt angry, harsh, and cruel. But Sunday morning, when the sun rose, the earth trembled with joy beneath her, and the tree knew that God's love had changed everything. It made the first tree beautiful. It made the second tree strong. And every time people look at the third tree, they'll think of God and the wonderful thing he's given us. And that is better than being the tallest tree in the world.
This is from Isaiah chapter 40. O Zion, messenger of good news, shout from the mountaintops. Shout it louder, O Jerusalem. Shout and do not be afraid. Tell the towns of Judah your God is coming. Yes, the sovereign Lord is coming in power. He will rule with a powerful arm. See, he brings his reward with him. He comes. He will feed his flock like a shepherd. He will carry the lambs in his arms, holding them close to his heart. He will gently lead the mother sheep with their young. So, go tell it on the mountain.
Over the hills and everywhere. And heaven and nature sing, and heaven and heaven.
Disperse the gloomy clouds of the night, and let the shadows pour through light. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to be born in Israel.
Held with glory and blinding light, haste to understand. In the bleak midwinter, peaceful child for man.
This is from the book of Micah. But you, O Bethlehem Ephrathah, are only a small village among all the people of Judah. Yet a ruler of Israel, whose origins are in the distant past, will come from you on my behalf. The people of Israel will be abandoned to their enemies until the woman in labor gives birth. Then at last, her fellow countrymen will return from exile to their own land. And he will stand to lead his flock with the Lord's strength in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God. Then his people will live there undisturbed, for he will be highly honored around the world, and he will be the source of peace.
And
This is from the book of Matthew. Then Herod called for a private meeting with the wise men, and he learned from them when the star first appeared. Then he told them, "Go to Bethlehem and search carefully for the child. And when you find him, come back and tell me so that I can go and worship him too." After this interview, the wise men went their way, and the star they had seen in the east guided them to Bethlehem. They went ahead of them and stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were filled with joy. They entered the house and saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasure chests and gave him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. When it was time to leave, they returned to their own country by another route, for God had warned them in a dream not to return to Herod.
Hark the herald angels sing, and then we be kings for our last 2 minutes.
Star of light, star with royal beauty bright, westward.
This is from the book of Romans, verse 13. I pray that God, the source of hope, will fill you completely with joy and peace because you trust in Him. Then you will overflow with confident hope through the power of the Holy Spirit. This is a poem I was asked to read. It was read several years ago. I don't know who to give credit to for the author of it. Was it Harry Bechtel? A good name? Wow. 'Twas the night before Jesus came, and all through the house, not a creature was praying, not one in the house. Their Bibles were laying on the shelf without care, in hopes that Jesus would not come there. The children were dressing to crawl into bed, not once ever kneeling or bowing their head. And Mom in her rocker, with baby on her lap, was watching the late show while I took a nap. When out of the east there arose such a clatter, I sprang to my feet to see what was the matter. Away to the window I flew like a flash, tore open the shutters and threw up the sash. When what to my wondering eyes should appear but angels proclaiming that Jesus was here. With a light like the sun sending forth the bright ray, I knew in a moment this must be the day. The light of his face made me cover my head. It was Jesus returning, just like he said. And though I possessed worldly wisdom and wealth, I cried when I saw him in spite of myself. In the book of life, which he held in his hand, was written the name of every saved man. He spoke not a word as he searched for my name. When he said, "It's not here," my head hung in shame. The people whose names had been written with love, he gathered to take his Father above. With those who were ready, he arose without a sound, while all the rest were left standing around. I fell to my knees, but it was too late. I had waited too long and thus sealed my fate. I stood and I cried as they rose out of sight. Oh, if only I had been ready tonight. In the words of this poem, the meaning is clear. The coming of Jesus is drawing near. There's only one life. And when comes this last call, we'll find that the Bible was true after all.
Thank you, John. And thank you, everybody who helped with the music. And thank you to the CE board who put this service together for today. This is definitely just a stripped down version of a Christmas program of just simply singing Christmas carols that give glory to God and hearing His word today. And so we close today with those thoughts that God's word is real. It's true. May it ring true in our hearts as we go to celebrate His birth this week. So I say to you, I'm going to close with prayer, but before I do that, I want to remind everybody to make sure you get a gift bag on your way out. And did I miss something?
Okay.
So far, we have collected 14 Bibles. So,
I'm not a math person, so you can do the math. 1,000 minus 14. Still a lot to go, but we got a good start. So yeah, a couple weeks in, we've already got 14. So keep them coming, and we're going to give God glory that way as well. Thank you for reminding me of that. And just a quick reminder that December 24th, we'll get together at 6 o'clock with Wekaskwan Community Church for our Christmas Eve service. And just know, Rachel, I, and the boys will be gone for the next week, so we will not be in town. So next week, you get to hear Pastor Dave Macaluso. He will be sharing the message next week from Wekaskwan. And so he will be here, and we will be in Ohio. So I hope you all have a wonderful, wonderful Christmas, and hope to see you on Christmas Eve at Wekaskwan. And there's the address up there on the screen. And let's go to God in prayer. Lord God, we thank you that you personally came to this earth to live among us. May we not lose sight of that this Christmas season. You are the greatest present any of us could ever receive. And that's why we gather together each week. That's why we try to bring your word to as many people as we can, that they may come to know and love you the way you have loved us. We lift this service to you, and we lift up our congregation to you and this community to you. And I pray your blessing over them as they walk through those doors today. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you. The Lord be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. And all God's people said, amen. 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 Merry Christmas. I hope to see you on Christmas Eve.